Well, this is Dr. Mark Hitchcock here in my office in Edmond, Oklahoma, and I want to welcome you to another episode of Marking the Times. This is a cold time here in Oklahoma. I hope it's a lot better where you are. This is some of the coldest weather we've had, I think, in maybe 50 years here in Oklahoma. It's going to get down maybe 10 below zero, actual temperature coming up. So it's quite a time here in Oklahoma. So I hope you're able, wherever you are, to enjoy some good warm weather. While we're in the deep freeze here, I think that the polar vortex has descended upon us. What I want to talk with you about, though, in this episode of Marking the Times is a little bit about China and prophecy. I've talked about this, I know, sometimes in bits and pieces here and there, but kind of wanted to bring this together because we're hearing a lot now, obviously, about China, and it's not going to go away. President Trump put a lot of tariffs on China, and really, I think, you know, has done a lot of things that brought them to the place where they are now and willing to talk more. But now we have with President Biden, we'll see what he does and how he deals with China. But he had his first long conversation with President Xi this last week. Evidently, it was a two-hour conversation. But a lot of people wonder as they look at our world today, you know, kind of where different nations will fit in. We've talked a lot about American prophecy and what the Bible does and doesn't say about that. But really the other a really rising superpower today in the world is China. And so that raises a question, obviously, about their place in the future. Really, the main passage that would relate to China in the end times is in it's Revelation chapter 16. And beginning in verse 12, we have here the this is the judgments that are being poured out. These are the bowls of wrath. You've had the seven seals that have been poured out or opened. Then you had the seven trumpets. And now it's the seven seal or the seven vials or bowls. This is the last series of judgment before the end of the age and the second coming of Christ. And this is the sixth angel or the sixth bowl judgment. The sixth angel poured out his bowl upon the great river, the Euphrates. And its water was dried up that the way might be prepared for the kings from the east. Literally, it's from the rising of the sun. And this is where a lot of people get the idea of China being mentioned in Scripture in the end times. And you notice it says the Euphrates River is dried up to make way for these kings of the east. And the reason the Euphrates is dried up is they're coming into the land of Israel. So these are nations east of the Euphrates River. And it says, I saw coming out of the mouth of the dragon and out of the mouth of the beast and out of the mouth of the false prophet, three unclean spirits like frogs. Of course, that's the unholy trinity, the counterfeit trinity, the dragon, the beast, or the antichrist and the false prophet. For they are spirits of demons performing signs which go out to the kings of the whole world to gather them together for the war of the great day of God Almighty. And then down in verse 16, they gather them together in the place which in Hebrew is called Harmageddon or Armageddon. So this is the final gathering of these nations in the land of Israel, the northern part of Israel, where they will gather there. And this really not a battle, but more of a campaign of Armageddon is unleashed in that part of the world in Israel. But it says here, the kings of the east, the Euphrates River is dried up for these kings to come in. And notice it's plural. So I believe it's nations clearly from the east of the Euphrates. But that can include, you know, Pakistan, India, Afghanistan, China, Korea, Japan, many nations. And so certainly it'll be some kind of a confederation of these nations. But I think China certainly will be a part of this. I don't think it's only China, but if we look at things happening today in our world, certainly they would be a part of this kings from the east that are gathered together for Armageddon. Now, a lot of people make a connection between this passage and the sixth trumpet judgment back in Revelation chapter 9, because in both passages, the Euphrates River is mentioned. Back in Revelation chapter 9, these demons are unleashed at the river Euphrates for the day and the hour, the specific time. They unleash this massive army that's numbering 200 million that will go out to destroy one-third of the people on the earth. And so since both mention a massive army here, it's the kings of the east. Back in Revelation 9, it's the army of 200 million. And the Euphrates River is mentioned in both passages. A lot of people equate the two. Years ago, I remember reading this, and this is my copy of Dr. Walvoord's book, the original one, The Revelation of Jesus Christ. And I had the privilege with another man to edit and update this commentary. But this is the old copy. And in a footnote on page 166, talking about the army of 200 million, Dr. Walvoord wrote this, and this commentary came out in, I think it was 1966. But he says, Time magazine on May 21st, 1965, page 35, said that Red China alone claims to have a man and woman militia of 200 million, exactly the figure of Revelation 9:16. So Dr. Walvoord kind of equated these two passages, took the kings of the East as this army of 200 million that he did equate with China, at least primarily. A couple of things about this. What I do, back in Revelation 9, the 200 million army, I think that's a demonic army. I don't think it's a human army. One of the reasons is the fifth trumpet that was just blown, obviously, before the sixth trumpet, is a demonic invasion of earth. They seem to be connected to one another. And there's a lot of things in that passage that this seems to be a supernatural rather than a natural army. So I don't equate those two passages. So really, if we want to find China in the pages of prophecy, really this kings of the East here in Revelation chapter 16 would be the main place. But again, I don't think it's China only. It's a confederation of these Eastern nations that will come down and pour down into the land of Israel in the very end for the campaign of Armageddon, where these armies will be destroyed by the second coming of Jesus Christ. And so I think that's really all we really would know from Scripture about China's place in the future, according to the Bible. So I hope that's helpful as you look at China today. People may ask you questions about, you know, China's role in prophecy. Those are a couple of passages that you can discuss with people and hopefully give them some insight. Again, what the Bible does say, but also what it doesn't say. And again, the Bible doesn't satisfy all of our curiosities. It doesn't give us all the answers. Not every nation is mentioned, but I think that's a little bit of insight of what China will do and the part they will play in this end time drama. Well, thank you for joining us. God bless you, and I hope you have a good week.